In this video, I'm going to show you how you can insert slicers and timelines into your pivot tables in Excel. Be sure and check out my other videos on pivot table basics so you can see the basic functionality and how you can start playing around with and creating pivot tables on your data. I'm Sharon Smith. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let's get started. All right, here I have a data set of wellness products and sales information, and I've converted this to a table and we've inserted a few different pivot tables down here. So I'm going to click on one of these, and this is where I have a pivot table that's showing me my total sales by product and also the profit margin. And so let's say I want to take a different view of this and look at this in different ways. What we can do is come up to Pivot Table Analyze, and up here under your filters, you have an insert slicer. So let's click on that. And then we can insert slicers here. So let's say we want to look at this at by salesperson. If we select this as one of our slicers and click OK, then over here it gives us all of our different salespeople that we can select. So we can choose one, or if we hold our control button, we can select multiple, and we can see different data. Our data will update based on our slicers here. So you can have multiple slicers over here, and it's just a way that you can help visualize your data and analyze it and filter it in different ways. Now let's go ahead and also go back up. Let's click on our pivot table, go up to Pivot Table Analyze, then click on Insert Timeline. Then this gives us an option to select our sale date for our timeline. This is the main date point of data in our spreadsheet. So let's click on that and click OK. And then down here, this is this little timeline that we can go ahead and select different dates. So let's say we wanted to do all of Q1, so January, and then we can drag and select February and March. So that gives us our Q1 2023 data. So it's a nice way that we can use both slicers and timelines to filter and view our pivot table data. Don't forget to watch my other videos on pivot table basics, charts, and also how to create inserted calculated fields in your pivot tables. Thanks for watching.